process? Are you still putting a lot of new stuff in? Are you starting to get to where it's reviewing?
Yeah, a lot of review. Once you get through 12, you're finding more situational football. You know, you're trying to go through your checklist of things that give you guys a chance to see that are game-like, you know, whether you're going through 2-minute or 4-minute or overtime or last plays of the game, coming outs, all those things that happen in a game you get a chance to teach. Those are the things at this point in camp we're going through. You have some subtle, you know, little things you're installing over the course of that. But really, at this point, the best thing we get to do is kind of situational mastery and kind of go through and really get a chance to teach. So it's a really good time for us.
How's the grading out of that situational work coming out? But how are they performing in those drills?
Good. I think more than anything, when you get like the first day of doing it, you get a chance to kind of really get back and get the film on. Like you get a 4-minute today for the first time of camp, you know. And you go teach in the morning, go through it, did a nice job. And I think we're going to look at the film and get a lot out of it, you know. So you get a chance to do that again in a scrimmage, hopefully. Get a chance to do it again before camp a couple times before you get in that first game. And it really gives you a chance to own it, you know.
Both Mastro and Mario were talking about how the offense is advanced compared to last year. Some of that being natural, that guys were all back for the most part. And some being that there's more freedom for Justin with audibles, or that Jake and him are back and it's, you know, the battery there. How do you see it advance? What has changed by way of advancement relative to a year ago?
Yeah, I think that's we've come a healthy way with that in regards to guys that understand what we're trying to get done and giving them some freedom to do stuff. I think that's, you know, Jake Hansen, I think you're referring to, right? It's from Breland. Jake and Justin, in regards to, let's use protection as an example, you know, communicating on things and being able to move protections around and really advance themselves in that regard as an example. I think that you've got a little more of the playbook because, you know, guys have heard it for the first time, you know. And so they've been excited about that, and it's been really good. They worked on that since spring and gone into summer, and I think camps, they've done a really nice job continuing that.
I know Addison was obviously here last year, but he was redshirting, but how different is this, not just with him, but with him and Jawan? Talking about with Jawan in the slot, he's been talking about that's different for him, and this is quite a skyscrapers package by way of personnel if you explore that possibility with both him and Jawan on the field.
Yeah, you know, that's right now still probably in number 12 the thing we're doing most. You've got, you know, the number of reps of guys out there. Obviously losing Schooler was a blow to us, but now we've got some guys really that haven't really played that much together, right? So you're trying to find chemistry between Herbert and the group and the quarterbacks, and moving those guys in some different places to see what can matchups you may be able to find or leverage you can play is something we're playing with. You know, Addison's done a real good job in camp of coming forward, but and Jawan, moving him around, it's been good, man. So keeping those guys connected and getting chemistry there is really, really important for us in day 12, you know.
I've done 2-minute, 4-minute today. How important is the result of that drill on the field, 11-on-11, and how much of it is really now you get to go watch each guy, how they handled their assignment, how they handled themselves situationally?
Well, I think the results, obviously, you're not in a game situation. You try to get as close to it as you can with the refs in a thud period. You're not going all the way to the ground. Can you really judge, you know, that? But I think there's a ton you can go in and say, hey, look, we had an advantage here. That's a nice job. We were successful in that regard. We weren't. So as far as grading it goes, you can absolutely grade it, and I think that's really important for us. So I think ultimately for us, being able to look back and say, okay, do we understand the concept and what we're trying to get done? Did we accomplish what we were trying to get done in that regard with knowing it's a thud period and not a game situation? So we can definitely look at it and be critical.
Having a scrimmage already in the books, what are those things that you're expecting to carry over into the second one that you want to see from the offense?
Continued growth. You know, I think you take the first scrimmage and you find, you know, some of the guys that they're looking at, and now you continue the growth process, you know, and that's really got to be the thing every single day, is like growth over outcome. You know, we want to continue to grow and grow and grow and not just focus on, you know, the end product each day. So scrimmage two, you look back, we're going to make sure we talk about scrimmage one in regards, talk about the situations we had during the week, and then scrimmage two, apply all those things and go to work, you know, and get ourselves closer to a product we think we are after 2 weeks.
What were the things that you applied this week based off the first scrimmage?
Based off the first scrimmage, there was a lot of stuff. I mean, you end up doing, you know, that first scrimmage, you have a bulkier stuff in by 8 and 9, right? I think now we get a few more situational things that we can work on, moving some guys in maybe some different spots, you know, playing with tempo still, playing fast, reducing things that may have come up as mental errors on one situation that may not happen now in number scrimmage two. Basically taking that inventory of things, okay, we didn't like what we did those things come up again, you know, trying to eliminate those.
Tight end's another spot, like wide receiver, we were able to try some new with Breland out and with McCormick not full go, you're able to see Bay and Camp Moyer's been out there. Webb, too. Are you able to look a little bit more down the depth chart at that position, too?
Yeah, you're kind of forced to, you know, with Breland and Cam, when with Breland and Cam out. Now you're forced to use some other guys that may not have many reps. Again, that's that chemistry between the whole group. And so you've got to try to find a way to see where that fits in with those guys, you know, and Camp and Bay, two guys who've been around but haven't had the bulk of what we've done, you know. And then you bring along the young guys with Patrick and Spencer and kind of see what they can do to help you and basically shrink the gap between those elderly guys, the elder guys and the younger guys.
It was certainly the case in the spring already with Cyrus moving up and kind of legitimizing that he can be an every down guy, but mm-hmm. It's no small feat. I mean, look, last year he was a goal line guy and a short yardage guy, and how much has he proven each day that goes by that he's going to be capable of helping shoulder the load compared to CJ and Travis and be a third complementary piece?
Yeah, Cyrus has done an awesome job. I mean, he's done it from last season to now. He's one of those guys in that upper echelon of guys who's put his best foot forward and really said, hey, there's not I want more than maybe what we had, and in regards to protection and doing some other things that maybe Die and CJ have kind of done a little bit more of. You know, he's done an awesome job, and Cyrus works his tail off. He's a epitome of a guy who goes out every day and does his job, and I think he's going to prove to himself and prove to us that he can do more than just that goal line short yardage stuff. He's done a great job.
When you have a guy like that who wants more, what does that say about himself as a player, as a person?
We recruited right. Yeah, you recruited right. You want guys who love the game, who want to play. You know, they got to have that burning desire, that intrinsic motivation to kind of go out there and be great. And I think he's a perfect example of what you're looking for. It makes us feel like we've got the right guy. You've got a leader. You've got a guy with some glue. And I think that he's done an awesome job of that, man.
What kind of progress have you seen from Cale Millen? Obviously, there's some foot stuff he was dealing with in the spring, but how have you seen progression this fall?
Yeah, Cale's done a good job. He's didn't have much in spring because of his foot, like you mentioned. Come out in fall camp and really tried to dive into the playbook and understand as much as he can. I use the analogy of drinking through a fire hose, you know, in camp as a freshman. You know, it's just there's a lot coming fast. There's a lot of situations and a lot of little things that you got to do fundamentally and technique-wise to put yourself in position to be successful. And so he's done a good job each day. There's a lot of learning bits. He's had a lot of things that he's able to learn from film and from Justin and from Tyler and seeing what we're doing. And that you're fortunate to get. You don't get all those things in high school, but he comes from a great background. He's learning fast.